everyone, it's Vanessa. I'm here with my next wrap-up. The first book that I wanted to talk about is Born a Crime by Trevor Noah. This is a book that has been so buzzed about and that I kind of put off reading. When Trevor Noah came onto the scene and took over The Daily Show, I was not that enthused. I used to be a big Daily Show watcher when Jon Stewart was the host, and when Trevor Noah came on, I just didn't really feel the want to continue watching the show. I didn't know much about him, his life, his comedy, or anything like that. And reading this book and listening to it on audiobook, because that's the way I consumed it, really sealed how great of a storyteller Trevor Noah is. He just has a way of telling stories to you that is entertaining, emotionally resonant, thoughtful, heartwarming, shocking, and fascinating. The voices that he makes for different people in his life are also really entertaining and fun to listen to. So for me, it was on full display the versatility that he has, not just as a storyteller, but as a voice comedian. There was also more than funny to this book. This book really did get you in the heart. And I think the majority of this comes through learning about his mother, her perseverance, the way that she dismissed tradition and wanted to pave her own way in life in South Africa when apartheid was happening. Also just hearing what it's like to be raised as a mixed race child in South Africa when this was happening, knowing that you shouldn't be alive. And the things that him and his mom would do to kind of circumvent the attention that would bring is just sad and devastating, but also really fascinating to see how they got around that. There were definitely some parts that I thought had my attention a little bit more than others, like when he was talking about his mother and his family. I was super into it. And then there were some parts towards the end where he was talking more about school and talking about when he left school and what he did for jobs. And that didn't really grab my attention as much as when he would be talking about his family. But none of that means anything because this book is still so worth your time. Definitely great on audiobook, something I would definitely recommend on audio. The next thing that I read was Goldie Vance Volume 3. This is the third installment in this mystery comic series. It was really great to be back with Goldie and kind of the adventure she gets into, seeing the mystery that is taking place right now. And it's her basically trying to figure out who's trying to sabotage the race car of her race driving enemy. And her name is Sugar Maple, of course. I love hearing Goldie try to decipher what's going on. And the mystery is always fun in a very lighthearted way. This is not heavy at all. And that's why I keep coming back to it. So I loved that. And I loved the relationship between Sugar and Goldie transforming and changing as the comic was going on, and then trying to see how they misunderstood each other and how they can go forward as friends. The artwork, as always, is so, so great. This is exactly like my aesthetic. I don't really know like the technical terms for any of this, but I just know that when I look at this, my eyes are just happy. The third thing that I read is Inside Out and Back Again, and this is a verse novel that follows Ha. She is a Vietnamese girl that is living in Saigon during the Vietnam War. When her mother and brothers decide they are going to leave, so they get on a boat and they travel to America to find refuge. And they end up in Alabama, and they're hosted by a family there. And it's Ha going to school and learning English and also just feeling different because of that, particularly because there are groups of black kids that hang out together and white kids that hang out together, and she is an Asian girl that is kind of in the middle, doesn't know where she fits in. It's her being bullied and her trying to understand why these kids are acting that way, her meeting other people in the community that are helpful to her. What I really enjoyed about this first novel is how much in the senses we were with her background and, you know, the kinds of foods she eats, the kinds of traditions that she follows. I think I will never be like a super lover of verse novels, and it's probably because I don't really know all the intricacies. Like, I can tell this probably took a lot to write, and it's coming from an own voices author who went through something similar as the main character. But for me, I feel like I would have gained a little bit more if this had been a normal novel structure, because I didn't get to know the characters very well. It was only like 2.5 hours on audiobook, and I was done so quickly that I was just left wanting to know the characters more, especially the father, who is kind of a focal point in the beginning of the book. So I would recommend this if you're looking for something short, if you're looking for a middle grade read, if you're looking for something that is in verse. It was definitely not my favorite thing that I've read for my multicultural lit for children class, but it was a very interesting interesting book and I'd never heard of it before I was assigned to read it. The next thing that I want to talk about is Far From the Tree, and this is the National Book Award winner, I think, for young people's literature this past year. And it follows three siblings who were separated by adoption, them getting to know each other, finding each other, and them trying to decide, do we want to also look for our biological mother? The book is told in alternating points of views between the three main characters. We have Claire, we have Maya, and we have Joaquin, and they kind of go back and forth in third person. I know that this book needs to be dramatic because of the subject that we are dealing with, and this is very heavy for these characters, but I thought that at some points it was a little bit too much. It was a little bit overwrought. It was a little bit overdramatic, and I think the majority of this has to do with the fact that I listened to it on audiobook, and I think that the narrator put on these voices that got tedious and fastidious to listen to after a while, particularly when she would do male voices. Whenever she would do Joaquin and got her voice really deep,
hey guys,
I was just like not that happy listening to it. Also, this book faltered and it felt less new the more that it went on, because it sort of became known to me that all of these characters were filling in for some trope. Like, we have Joaquin, who is a boy who has like been forgotten through all the foster families that he's been going through, and for that reason he has this backstory of a violent episode that he's never forgotten, and for that reason he doesn't feel like he can open up to anybody, and he's really sensitive at heart but he can't open up. Then we have Claire, who gave birth before the book opens, gave up her child, and then the third person, Maya, is just like the stubborn, loud, kind of annoying sister in the group, and she brings the comedy and sarcasm that, again, at times I felt a little bit hard to listen to on audiobook. What I really liked about this book is how it focused on family and these siblings, because I feel like when I was growing up, YA really focused on romantic relationships, and I like that this one really focused on familial relationships. But I do think that the ending was a little bit too simplistic and happily ever after. I'm glad that they got to know each other and they're together, but it felt like all the pieces fit so well for everybody at the end, and everybody got what they wanted at the end, that it didn't leave that much of an impact, I guess, is what I want to say. And last but not least, I just finished last night, Text Me When You Get Home, and this is a nonfiction book that's a little bit like a memoir slash sociology look at female friendship. How the author does this is by exploring her own ideas about female friendship from when she was really young to now, how that has evolved the way we look at female friendships. And Schaefer really argues in this book that we as women want to put those female relationships kind of on the same pedestal as we put romantic and familial relationships. And she delves a lot into pop culture female friendships, like those you see on Parks and Rec, Insecure, Big Little Lies, Grey's Anatomy. She mentions a little bit about the history of female friendship, the biology and the reasoning why we would want to remain friends with other women as we get older and go through different life stages. This, again, was things that you kind of know are easy to understand why that is. Not anything necessarily mind-blowing, but I think overall this book was a fun listen on audiobook and a quick listen on audiobook. It's just like a nice cozy read to make you feel warm inside about the female friendships in your life, I think. It was a bit repetitive, not mind-blowing, but a nice listen. And that's it for me and my wrap-up. Thanks so much for listening. If you read any of these or would like to read any of these, let me know in the comments. I will hopefully get back to you with the things that I'm currently reading, slash also a little bit of a haul of books that were laying around that I picked up and are now mine. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye bye.